Hello students, welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss about EMF and the internal resistance. When you have a battery, actually EMF stands for electromotive force. Electromotive force is nothing but that is provided by the battery. We know that battery is the source for any circuit, and the battery will provide the potential difference, that is voltage. Voltage is nothing but the electromotive force. So it will provide the force to push the electrons in the external circuit, right? So this electromotive force is provided by the battery. So battery is the source which provides the electromotive force. And the electromotive force, see, by the term itself you can understand it is electromotive force, the force provided to move the electrons. Movement of electrons is nothing but the current. So the flow of current is done by the force provided by the battery, right? So EMF of a battery, actually it is given as the force, right? But here it defines the voltage provided by the battery when no current flows in the circuit, in the external circuit. That is, when you have an idle battery, and when you check for the voltage of the battery when it is newly bought, no, that new battery or cell without making use of the battery, that is in the idle condition, no circuit is connected with the battery and no current flows in the circuit. Then when it is in idle state, if you check for the EMF, I mean, if you check for the voltage of the battery, that voltage, that particular voltage is called as the EMF. So this electromotive force, as I said, the force provided for movement of electron is just for your understanding and to have it in mind, right? So EMF is what? When the battery is in the idle condition and no current flows because of this battery, that is, this battery does not do anything and the full voltage of the new battery is called as the EMF. Okay, and EMF is indicated by the symbol psi. So this is what is the symbol. Next, what you're going to understand is internal resistance. So by the term itself, again, to understand, internal resistance is nothing but resistance provided internally inside the battery is called as the internal resistance. That is, resistance is a term related to resistor, right, which resists the current flow. Without adding any resistor to the circuit or something, battery by itself will have some resistance inside the battery. This is because of the battery is made up of, we know that it is all made up of electrodes and electrolyte, right? Electrodes is, we will be having, for a battery, you'll be having one anode and one cathode, and then it will have some electrolyte. So when you supply voltage, what will happen? The electrons from the positive side will move on to the negative electrode. A negative electrode will, ions from the negative electrode will move towards the positive side. This is what is made as the electron flow inside the battery, and the excess electron will flow outside the battery as the current, right? This is how the battery works. And this flow of ions and electrons between the electrodes, electrolytes, will have some resistance by the electrodes itself. Few of the ions, if it is positive, if it tries to move this side, this positive electrode will repel and will stop the flow of those ions. Similarly, very few amount of resistance will be happen between these electrodes and electrolytes inside the battery, and this small resistance inside the battery is called as the internal resistance. See, the resistance provided by the battery itself for what? To the flow of charges within the battery. This is called as your internal resistance. Actually, as I said, when you have the idle battery, if you check for the voltage, the total voltage is nothing but your EMF. For this case, as there is an in the real case of the battery, this as it is having some internal resistance inside, the EMF what you the original EMF of the battery cannot be calculated by the terminal voltage. When you check the voltage in the terminals of the battery, that will not be exactly total EMF of the battery, because you have some internal resistance and this will drop some voltage inside the battery by itself. So the EMF will not be equal to the terminal voltage as it is. And when you have a new battery, when you check for the terminal voltage, that will be almost equal to EMF, because for a new battery, it is internal resistance will be always very much lower. But once the battery is used, the internal resistance will get increased as the time exceeds, and the terminal voltage will not be equal to your EMF.